Friday, I leave my high school in the middle of New York to strive for our planet. My name is Xiye Bastida. I am a climate activist, and I am 17 years old.
Hi.
When do we want it?
Now!
If we don't get it!
Strike!
If we don't get it!
Strike!
If we don't!
We are joining young people from across the world who are demanding action on the climate crisis.
It's the only way in which youth can voice their opinions. Because we cannot vote, our civic duty is to go to school. But how are you asking us to go to school for a future that we might not be able to have?
We know that we're not the first generation of youth activists, and that is really inspiring because we know that when young people lead, change is made.
I was only 13 when I protested at my school, and I had no idea that it would change how American students can express themselves. I'm Mary Beth Tinker, and in 1965, I wore a black armband to school to mourn the dead in the Vietnam War and to call for a Christmas truce.
When the American Civil Liberties Union took our case to the Supreme Court, I found out that we had more power than I thought. And that's why I'm excited to meet the next generation of activists.
Xiye, why are you an activist?
You know, in 2015, my town in Mexico was affected by drought and flooding. Once I moved to New York City, I saw what Hurricane Sandy had done.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the moment where I realized the global capacity of this mm-hmm. issue.
How did it feel for you to organize your high school and get on the streets and speak up about something that you felt so passionate
about? It made me feel very empowered to tell my principal, I'm not asking for permission to go on strike, mm-hmm. I'm telling you what's gonna happen.
Young people have always changed the rules. When we wore black armbands to school, we didn't succeed in stopping war, but we did succeed in changing the rules to favor young people's voices, because when the Supreme Court ruled in favor of us, they said that young people should have a right to speak up in school.
That's amazing, because I feel like if that precedent hadn't been placed, maybe students could not protest or walk out of school. And I know that what we say when we walk out is, it's our right to do so.
Students sometimes ask me, well, do you have to get in trouble in order to take a stand? And I say, no. Definitely try to start with something that's not going to get you in trouble, or try to change the rules.
Exactly.
Like you did.
We changed the rules from, you know, skipping school because yeah. we had to mm-hmm. like making the school let us skip school.
Because some people like to say, oh, kids don't know anything. But as it turned out, I found out later, most adults didn't know anything about Vietnam. They couldn't even find it on a map.
For me, success is changing people's mindsets as we go, because with something like the climate crisis, mm-hmm. there is not going to be success until we reverse it.
A lot of success has to do with connecting with others. You don't have to be some big hero, or you don't have to be a big leader. You can just be you. That's what I learned. When you speak up for what you believe in, some people are going to get mad about it.
It's easy to not have hope. But what we say is that the only way to have hope is through action. Once you act, you feel empowered.
The Supreme Court ruling in Tinker versus Des Moines was a great affirmation for the rights of young people like you. And so I'm so glad that you're carrying on the tradition.
Yes, we are.
If you liked that video, I hope you did. Subscribe here, because there's plenty more where that came from.